squad car. Squad cars. General Motors and their dealer organizations throughout Southern Africa proudly bring you the drama, the danger, the thrills, and the facts when the long arm of the law travels in squad cars.
Eager Viva Deluxe has its war paint on. A brilliant new side flash of chrome and color. Climb inside the Viva Deluxe now and watch the world beat a rapid retreat in your rearview mirror.
Yes, Eager Viva has the sporting streak. With a bold sweep of chrome and sheer line elegance, Vauxhall Viva brings the world's ideas of family transport right up to date.
But we don't expect you to take leave of your sense for looks alone. Viva is the car that puts the fun back in motoring. The tireless 1 liter engine is one reason.
And there's the way Viva delivers its power with four on the floor gear shift. There's the way it holds the road with anti-roll suspension.
With Viva's pace and space, all you leave behind is the traffic.
See a Vauxhall dealer now for your Viva Deluxe or super luxury Viva SL.
And now, squad cars.
Johannesburg, outside the magistrate's court, July the 21st, 3:20 p.m. Squad car man, Warrant Officer Ruas, is standing on the steps watching the people leaving the building. At length, he sees the face he's looking for.
Joe?
Hi.
Joe? Hello, Joe. How goes it?
Oh, it's you. What have I done now?
No, I'm not here to pick you up.
Well, what did?
I told my wife about you. She made me parcel some clothes up and bring them to you.
Well, now there's a thing. You know, all my long life, I never had anything for nothing till now.
There's a blanket in there, too. It'll help keep you warm a bit.
Well, why are you doing this for me?
Because we have a little more than you. And even after we've given these things to you, we'll still have enough.
Well, I've never known such kindness. Why?
I just told you.
Yeah, well, there's got to be some other reason. You think I was hard done by?
I never believed you stole from that store. I thought the store detective was making a mistake. The manager was determined to lay charges against you.
Oh, I don't blame you.
I know you didn't. But I felt bad all the same.
No, it wasn't your fault at all. I never thought for a moment it was. I'm not one to bear grudges.
Anyway, we decided to keep an eye on you. Watch your progress. I'm glad you got off.
A good magistrate, eh? He knew I never stole them things. When a man gets to my age, he becomes forgetful sometimes. And when that big man stopped me at the store entrance, I was very surprised. He says, will you please accompany me to the manager's office? Well, what for, says I? You stolen that shirt and vest, he says. Not I says. Anyway, you're coming with me, he says, and that was it. Next thing I knew, you and that other policeman turned up, drove me to Parkview Police Station. I forgot, man. I had money.
You don't have to convince me, Joe. I know how it was. But it was the manager's and the store detective's word against yours.
All my life, I never laid a finger on nothing that didn't belong to me. When I'm poor, I don't mind admitting that, but I'm clean and I keep my hands to myself.
Never mind, Joe. It's all over now. But my wife said that with all this cold weather about, you'd be needing something to put under your jacket besides newspaper. So she parcels these things up for you.
Well, I never known such kindness. I thank you for it.
Look after yourself, Joe.
You will. Thanks very much. And tell your wife the old man sends his thanks to her, too.
August the 23rd, 8:43 p.m. Warrant Officer Ruas and his partner, Sergeant Todu, have stopped their squad car at the scene of an accident on the corner of Bock and Claim Streets. They're in the process of trying to extricate the injured from the smashed vehicles concerned when Warrant Officer Ruas feels a tug on his sleeve.
What's happening here? What, anybody done for this?
Who's that?
Well, it's me, Joe Lights.
Hello, Joe.
How goes it?
But not so good. These people are badly hurt.
Listen, man. You showed me great kindness.
Yes.
I haven't forgotten. And I'm going to do you a good turn. I heard them planning the murder.
All right, Joe.
They're going to murder the old man and his wife. I heard them talking.
Joe, I'd like to talk to you some other time, but not right now.
Listen.
Look. I'll tell you what.
What?
Meet us here this time tomorrow night. We'll be able to talk then.
All right.
Okay?
On this corner. Quarter to nine.
And
tomorrow
it will
night.
Be better if you haven't had so much of a party.
Yeah. Okay. I'll see you tomorrow. Yeah, you've got plenty on your plate. Excuse me, please.
I think he's going a bit funny, you know. It happens sometimes when people get old. Did you call an ambulance?
Yes. They should be here very soon.
Right. Give me a hand with the steering wheel. We'll pull together. Right. You ready?
Yes.
August the 24th, 8:40 p.m. Having dealt with a disturbance in Plain Street, Warrant Officer Ruas and Sergeant Todu are cruising towards their rendezvous with Joe Lates on the corner of Bock and Claim Streets.
Oh, there he is.
Where?
Over there on the left.
Oh, well, he remembered. Pull up, Paul.
Okay.
Is that your warrant, officer?
Yes, it's me, Joe. How are you tonight?
Oh, better than I was last night. Better than this morning. Yeah, I was carrying a real bubble. My head and stomach was getting their own back for what I did to them last night. Yeah, that was a bad smash here last night, eh?
Yes, it was. The woman died in hospital.
They drive too fast these days. It's the youngsters. They see no danger.
I'm afraid you're right. I'm sorry I couldn't talk to you last night.
No, that's all right. I could see you was busy.
You said something about a murder.
Yeah, that's correct, yeah.
You said you heard somebody planning
it. That's right.
You're not setting us off on a wild goose chase, are you?
No, I wouldn't do a thing like that. I'm just wanting to repay your kindness. And when I heard of this thing, I thought, here's something for me old friend, Warrant Officer Ruas. Well, was lucky I bumped into you. I was in two minds whether I should phone you or not.
So tell us. Yeah. Get in the car.
Yeah.
Out of the cold.
All right. Yeah. Oh, that's much better.
So, tell me.
Yeah. Well, have a night it was. It was bitterly cold, man. Now, during the day, I'd taken up with a man I met in Joubert Park. And he said to me they was having a bit of a party later that night. Well, he said he'd take me along. Now, it was in the boiler room of a place called Kennaway Mansions in Dornfontein.
Mm.
All nice and warm there it was. A lot of these Sherry Gang people sleep there.
Yes, we know about it. Go on.
Well, anyway, we had this party, see, and it's too late to be going home. So what happens? This friend of mine suggests that I'd bed down for the night. Well, it seemed a sensible thing to do, so I did. Now, I don't know what time it was when I woke up, but I heard these two men talking.
Hobos?
No. No, they was youngsters. Early 20s, I'd say. What do you call these lads with the long hair?
Hippies.
No. They're okay. The others.
Ducktails.
Yeah, that's it.
Go on.
Well, anyway, they're thinking everybody's asleep, see? But I'm listening. Now, I make like I'm breathing heavy, you know, so I can hear them talking.
Yeah.
And the one is telling the other about this plot. I suppose you'd call it that, out Bryanston way. There's an old man and his wife. They live there, see, alone.
Mm.
Now, what was their names again? Wilkins, that's it. Now, apparently, they got a bit of money. And that's what these two chaps said anyway, see.
Yes.
But they're keeping on the place, see.
Yeah. So these two are set on getting at it, huh?
That's right, yeah.
Now, where is this place?
Well, I'm not quite sure. Somewhere out north.
You said Bryanston.
Yeah, I know I did, but I'm thinking now. Was it Bryanston? What's that other place out there?
Ferndale.
now, wasn't it?
Craigle?
Yeah, that's right, Craigle. Now, apparently, there's a plot or something by the river.
Shouldn't be too hard to find.
No, it shouldn't. Go on, Joe.
Yeah, well, these two skillums are going to kill the old people, see, for their money.
When?
Oh, they talked about Saturday night. That'll be next Saturday, I suppose.
Our night shift, too.
Are you sure about this, Joe?
Oh, I'm positive.
And how are they going to do it? Did they say?
Oh, no, they didn't go so far as to say that. It's definite. 10 o'clock at night, they said.
Yes, I think we'll have to arrange a little reception committee for them. What do you say, Paul?
I think so. Should be fairly interesting.
Saturday, September the 4th, 8:55 p.m. Warrant Officer Ruiz and Sergeant Tadu, accompanied by a native constable, Thousand Sitoli, having ascertained the whereabouts of the few acres of ground owned by Mr. Wilkins, are dropped by a police car outside the gate.
It's certainly out of the way.
Yes, very isolated.
You see anybody about?
Mm-mm. Oh, there's a light at that window, though.
Come on, let's go and see.
Hey, what are you going to tell the old man?
I don't know. We don't want to alarm them.
Hey, what's that?
An Alsatian.
You know, I don't know why they're worrying. With a dog like this to protect them, they could only be safe.
You think so, eh? Watch. Yeah, boy, come. Shh, shh, shh. Come, boy. Come on. That's a good boy. Come on. Come. You see? He barks to begin with, but we can quickly make friends with him. Now, watch this. Thousand.
Sir.
Come here. Make to pat the dog.
Oh.
Go on.
Hey, you will bite me, sir.
How can he bite you, man? There's a wire fence between you.
Your dog.
Ah, that's enough. That's enough, Thousand. There we are. This chap will be useless against tonight's visitors. He likes Europeans.
I see.
You stay here, Thousand, till we get the dog locked up.
Yes, sir.
Come on, Paul. Come on, boy. Quiet. Come on. Come on, boy. Come on, boy, come.
You know, it beats me how an old couple can live in such an isolated place. I don't know, I'd be scared stiff.
You forget, Paul, that people haven't seen what you've seen.
Yeah, that's true.
I'll do the talking.
There's somebody coming.
Who's there?
Police, Mr. Wilkins.
What do you want?
Open up, please. We want to talk to you. Good evening.
Good evening. What's the trouble?
I wonder if you can help us.
Eh?
We need your help.
What for?
We want to set a trap. We'd like to do it in your kitchen.
Oh. Well, what's going on there? Is it chicken thieves?
Something like that.
Yes, of course. Come in.
If you'll just hold your dog until the police boy comes in, we won't have any casualties.
Oh, what? Oh, yes. Here, Caesar, come here. Come on. Now you can let the boy in.
Thousand!
Sir!
You can come in now.
It's, not often we have excitement in these parts.
Well, I think you'll find there'll be enough excitement later to last you a lifetime.
Can you get all this down to the co-op in time, Boot? It's quite a load. Better take the new Holden.
Sure. The new Big Six Holden pickup can take it. It's a wonder worker. Carries 3/4-ton loads and handles like a sedan. Carries its passengers in big car comfort. And it carries the name Holden, When Holden gives its name to a pickup, it's got to be good. That's why Holden mount a big six-cylinder 108 brake horse engine in their pickup and give it seven main bearings for longer life and smoother running. That's why Holden give their pickup double life construction, a loading floor topped with replaceable laminated wood and steel skid strips. It's born to the felt and a smooth operator around town. Yes, the Holden Big Six pickup is a wonder worker. It's a Holden, built for a country like ours.
The Wilkins Small Holding, Craig Hall, 9:15 p.m. The three policemen are in the kitchen of the house talking to the old man.
Where's your wife, Mr. Wilkins?
Well, we were just going to bed. She's through there.
Sorry to keep you up.
No, that's all right. Now, what do you want to do?
We'd like to get settled in the kitchen to wait for your visitors.
Oh, you know they're coming then, eh?
Yes, we've been tipped off. A police informer.
Well, just make yourself at home.
Thank you, Mr. Wilkins.
What do you want us to do?
You can go to bed. We won't be needing you. We just want to sit in the kitchen here.
Well, you're not going to be very comfortable. I'll get you some chairs.
Well, that's very kind of you. Don't put yourself to any trouble.
No, it's no trouble. There's nothing to sit on here. Rena.
What is it?
We've got visitors. Come and see. She'll be wondering what on earth it is. The only people who come here are my son and his wife. They sometimes drop in at the weekend.
Goodness gracious, what's all this?
It's the police.
Oh, yes, I can see that, but what do they want with us?
Nothing to be alarmed about, Mrs. Wilkins. I'm Warrant Officer Ruiz. This is Sergeant Tradoo.
Oh, how do you do?
Oh, how do you do?
Is it our boy you're after?
No.
I was going to say he's a good boy. Never gives us any trouble.
He's too old.
So if it's not the boy, what do you want?
It's chicken thieves.
Oh, I didn't know we had any round here.
Apparently, yes, we have.
What will they get up to next?
Nothing to be alarmed about, Mrs. Wilkins.
But what's it got to do with us?
Well, it's just that your house is conveniently situated. They come down this way. We've heard they're coming tonight. We want to be on hand to meet them.
Oh, I see. What time are they coming?
Our information says 10 o'clock.
Oh, have you had something to eat?
Yes, thank you. We had supper before we came on duty.
Would you like some tea or coffee?
No, thank you.
I'm just getting them some chairs.
Yeah, Mr. Wilkins. Let me take that.
Oh, thank you.
Well, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to bed. I don't want to be in your way. If you want anything, you must just ask.
All right, Mrs. Wilkins. Thank you.
Good night.
Good night to you.
Here you are. Now you've got three chairs.
Sergeant.
All right, sir.
Well, thank you, sir. There's not much an old man like me can do, so I'll be off to bed, too.
Don't be alarmed if you hear anything unusual.
No, that won't worry me. I'm getting deaf, you see. Good night.
Good night, Mr. Wilkins. Now then, Tarzan.
Sir.
Can you see the dog?
Just a minute, sir. Yes, sir.
Good. He's our early warning system. He's sure to bark when they arrive.
If they arrive. Joe Lades is an old boozer, you know. Perhaps he heard something, but he's got it all wrong.
We'll soon see. What time is it?
9:25.
Now listen, this is what we'll do. Thousand?
Yes, sir.
Put your chair behind the kitchen door. I think that's the way they'll come in.
Yes.
Even though the old folks keep it locked and bolted, it doesn't look very secure to me. A couple of good shoves, it'll be in. So you put your chair behind the door. Go on. That's right. You sit down. That's it. When they come, when they've opened the door, I want you to close it quietly. And then get down on the floor and use your body to stop them opening it again. You understand?
Yes, sir. Like a doormat, sir.
Yes, that's it. Now, that'll keep you out of trouble. That's all I want you to do. Close the door quietly, lie down across the bottom of the door so they can't open it again. That'll keep them in.
Yes, sir.
You'll also be out of the line of fire.
And us? What do we do?
We'll take our chairs. Come on. And we'll park them in the pantry.
Is this headquarters?
That's it. Center of operations. Sit, Paul.
It's now 9:40.
And let's hope they pitch up on time. You settled there, Thousand?
Yes, sir.
And for goodness sake, when they come, you keep your head.
Yes, sir.
You don't panic. You do exactly as I told you.
Yes, sir.
Smoke.
Yes, thanks.
I wonder what they'll have with them.
In the way of weapons, you mean?
Hmm.
We won't know till they get here.
No.
Nervous.
Aren't you?
Yeah.
Nice old couple, aren't they?
Hmm.
You know, what's the son doing letting them live off the beaten track like this?
I don't suppose it ever occurred to him that they could ever be in danger.
Yeah. Wait till we tell him.
I only hope we're not wasting our time.
Hmm. 10 p.m., 0 hour. With strained ears, the three policemen sit and listen. They hear nothing, and so they wait. p.m. Sergeant Tadou shuffles to relieve a stiffness in his knee.
Listen.
Do you think it's them?
It's about time. They're long overdue. Sit tight, Thousand. This sounds like it.
Yes, sir.
I wish there was a window in the building. There goes our early warning system.
He didn't worry them at all.
Just the way I said. Shh, 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 shh.
Two of them.
Hmm, sounds like it.
Hey, they're right outside the door.
Thank heavens they didn't go around to the front.
What are they doing?
Shh, shh, shh. Look at the light from the torch through the fanlight on the ceiling.
Yeah, it's gone now.
Hold tight. This is it. That door won't hold long.
One more and they'll be in.
What was that? The door.
What do you want to go and do that for?
I didn't. I thought it was you.
Wait a minute. Somebody here. Shine the torch. See? Hit him.
No, no, no.
Hit him again.
What are you doing here, eh? I'll kill you.
p.m. In the excitement, Constable Thousand Sitoli forgot to close the door quietly behind the two intruders. The discovery of Sitoli and the subsequent beating all happens very quickly. The two policemen in the pantry run through to the kitchen.
Shine your torch, Paul.
There.
Stand. This is the police.
It's the cops.
Get him.
We've killed your boy. We'll kill you too like this.
My shoulder.
Next time it'll be your head.
Paul, the torch.
I dropped.
Shoot. Shoot, poor man. Make our flash. Give us some light. That's it. See them?
Oh, let's get out of here.
Where's the door?
Nice shooting, Paul.
Hey, the other's by the door. Watch.
Yes, I see him.
He's down.
Hello. Light. Let me put the light on. Good gracious me, what's all this?
Nothing to be alarmed about, Mr. Wilkins.
I thought I heard people clapping their hands or
something. There's been some shooting.
I say. They are in a mess, aren't they?
Hey, the constable's been hit.
Where?
In the stomach.
Let me see. He's not dead.
No, sir. I am not dead.
Yeah, must have been a ricochet off the wall. Let's get him to hospital.
We'll take him in my car. I'll go and put on some clothes.
Do you want me to go with Mr. Wilkins?
You better.
What did they hit you with?
This.
Wow. An iron-shot pick handle.
Where did they get you?
My left shoulder. I think it's broken. Hit me across my right forearm, too. Could barely hold my gun. You?
Not a scratch.
My husband says you've made a mess in my kitchen.
Yes, I'm afraid we have, Mrs. Wilkins.
So you got them, eh?
Yes, yes.
Skellums. Would you like a cup of tea?
Don't worry, Mrs. Wilkins.
Well, if you change your mind, just put the kettle on and help yourself. I'm going back to bed.
Amazing, eh? She didn't even bat an eyelid.
She didn't know they came here to kill her and the old man.
Yeah, there's no reason they should ever know. They'd never feel safe here
right,
again.
I'm all ready. Now we can put the boy in the back. I'll just go and get the car out.
One of these monkeys is still alive. See? Yeah?
Yes. His eyelids are fluttering.
Can't see any wound on him.
My back.
No, don't touch it, Paul. Can you move at all?
No, I can't feel my legs.
He's paralyzed. Must have got him in the spine.
No hard feelings. You mustn't feel badly about it. You see, I would have killed you.
Ride with pride in the Ranger.
Build a car that South Africa will ride with pride. That was the challenge. And into action went General Motors with a task force of automasters from around the world. Stylists, engineers, technologists from England, the USA, and Germany teamed up with their South African colleagues. They probed, planned, checked, and tested. Ideas became blueprints. Blueprints became steel, glass, and rubber. Ranger was born.
Ride with pride in the Ranger.
Now South Africa has a car of its own, the Ranger. Not just a car, but a whole new generation of cars. Sleek four- and two-door sedans, spacious station wagons, and a swashbuckling fastback. Ranger's variety goes on and on. There's a choice of three engines and transmissions. See the Ranger, ride the Ranger.
Ride with pride in the Ranger!
The Bantu constable, Thousand Sitoli, had been hit in the stomach by a bullet fragment. It had traveled round his ribs and lodged in his back, just beneath the skin. It required a relatively minor operation to remove it. The Bantu constable made a rapid and complete recovery. One of the two would-be murderers had died immediately. The bullet that struck him traveled the length of his thorax, went up through his neck, and came to rest in his brain. The other man, paralyzed from the neck down, eventually died in hospital some months later. Mr. Wilkins and his wife Rena never knew that they had been potential murder victims.
The empty streets of night, waiting. In fast cars, on foot, living with crime and violence, these men are on duty 24 hours out of every 24. They face dangers at every turn, expecting nothing less. They protect the people of South Africa. They are the men of squad cars.
Wake up to an all-new feeling. It gets into your blood and gets you out of the ordinary. Viva Fever. Viva Fever. New feeling of Vauxhall's all-new Viva. Enjoy new performance. Biting new acceleration. Hush, hush, new suspension. Plush, new luxury. Everything's new about Viva at Vauxhall dealers now. Viva Fever. Why fight it?
Listen again next Friday evening to another authentic story in our dramatic South African police series, Squad Cars, brought to you by General Motors, makers of the biggest and most exciting range of cars, trucks, and commercial vehicles in the world. Cadillac, Buick, Oldsmobile, Pontiac, Beaumont, Chevrolet, Opel, Holden, Vauxhall, Bedford, GMC, and Ranger, South Africa's own car.